Hello again. So we have reached exercise 6, which again it's about finding a value, but however using here a binary search. So the input is the same, so we have an array, we have to find a value and we have to return the index. However, in order to apply the binary search, the array should be sorted, so we need to read a sorted array, and the method is exposed here. So I will explain it using an animation. So suppose that we have this array. So the array is sorted, it's called A, and it contains 16 elements. So the indices are from 0 to 15. So suppose now that you want to find 100. So in the normal sequential search, so we need to start from index 0 and traverse all the array till we reach its end. So at the end we'll not find the val, so we need to do 16 tests to check whether the element exists or not. So it's a waste of time. And then if suppose that we want to find minus 10, so again we will do the search. If you want to do the sequential search, you can tell me, okay, I can start from the beginning and say that, okay, if it's negative, so it doesn't exist. And the same for 100. So however, you can take the, you cannot sometimes start from the beginning or sometimes start from the end. So it's not a good solution, even if the array is sorted. So suppose now that I want to find 43. So 43 is not in the array, so I need to loop. So even if you want to end the searching whenever you exceed the number, so for example you compare 1 with 43, so forcibly it will be on the right side. So you compare 5, 6, 10, 15, 21, 25, 34, and then you reach 44 and you say, okay, 44 is greater than 43, so I couldn't find 43, and then I will end. So here we will expose a new method which is called the binary search or dichotomous search. So suppose that I want to find 88. So 88 is in the array, so we can look at it. However, while writing a code, we cannot look at all the elements at the same time, so we need to traverse one element at a time. So first we consider the whole array, so we will use two variables, two counters. We will call it lower and upper to indicate the indices of the lower and the upper array. So lower would contain 0 and upper would contain 15, which is the index of the index of n minus 1, so it's the size minus 1. So what we will do is that we will calculate the middle one. So we calculate the middle between 0 and 15, so it's equal to 0 plus 15 over 2, so it's equal to 7.5. So since we are using integers, so the middle would be equal to 7. So we will check 88 with the middle element. So we'll check 88 with 34. So since 88 is greater than 34, so obviously I will not find 88 in the left part of this array. It's obvious. So if I will find 88, it will be on the right side of 34 because 88 is greater than 34. So what we'll do now, I will consider a new array. So this array now, it will not start from index 0. It will start from index middle plus 1. So lower now would be equal to 8. So we'll start. So we have a new array which starts from 8 and ends at index 15. So again, I will do the same operation. So we'll consider the middle element. So the middle here is an index 8 plus 15 over 2, so it will be equal to 11.5. So we'll consider 11 since we are dealing with integers. So 50 is still smaller than 88. So obviously, I will not find 88 in the left part of this subarray. And then the lower element will be equal to middle plus 1. So we'll start from 12. And then we'll calculate the middle, 12 plus 15 over 2, it will be equal to 13.5, so in our case it will be 13. I will compare 88 with the element at index 13, I will find it, and then I can say that I have found the element. So I have done here just three tests. I've just compared the middle elements of each array, so we have just three elements, and we have concluded that the elements exist in the array. So it's a very fast search algorithm. So let's move and write the code. So let's start. So we have an array. So again, so it's the same as the previous exercise. So we have an array A of size, so 50 for our case. So we will need I for looping to read the array. We need a value to search for. We need the index. And we need two counters, lower and upper, to calculate the lower upper. And let's work with a middle one too. So we'll start by reading the index, the array size. So we'll do a while loop. So printf enter n. and then scanf percentage d address of n, and we will do that as long as n is less or equal to 0 or n is greater than size. And then we need to read the array. So we have already worked with that. So in order to read in a sorted array, we read first. So printf enter, let's say reading arrays first, reading array, sorted array. And then we need to read each element. So first we read the first element, and then we read all the other elements. So printf enter a of 0, and then we make a for loop, and inside the for loop we do a do while. So scanf percentage d address of a of 0, and then we do a for loop. So here it will start from 1, I less than n, I plus plus, and we will do a do while. So printf enter a of I, and we do a scanf a of I, and we do that as long as the newest element is less than the previous element. So we have read a sorted array, and then we need to enter a value to search for. So printf enter a value, and we have the value here. So we have read the array, the sorted array, the value, and we need now to do the searching. So at first, so let's repeat. So we have lower, upper, and middle. So let's initialize all these. So lower would be equal to 0. We'll start from the first of the array. The upper would be equal to n minus 1. And the middle one will do it inside the loop. And for the index, would be equal to minus 1 as in the previous exercise. So we'll still do that. So when I will finish, so as long as there's element, so as long as lower is less than upper, so as long as we have that, since the array is shrinking, so whenever we still have some element, so even if lower is equal to upper, it means that there's still one element, we will do that. So later on I will add some condition more here in order to stop the searching. So at each time I will calculate the middle, which is equal to lower plus upper over 2. So integer plus integer over integer is integer, and this is what we want. We want an integer index, so we don't want to cast or modify any of these variables to float or double. We don't want to promote the variable. So if the value that I'm looking for is less than a of middle, so it means that I need to go to the left side, so I will modify the upper value. So upper would be equal to middle minus 1. Otherwise, if val is greater, so we in the animation we have just worked with that, if it's greater than a of middle, we modify just the middle one. So middle would be equal to middle plus 1, to here the lower, which would be equal to middle plus 1. Otherwise, so if it's equal, I would save the index. Else, it means that val is equal to a of middle, so I would save in the index the value of middle. So again here, as we have done in the previous, so if I keep that, I keep looping, it means I will loop until there's no more elements. So if I have repeated elements, I could find one of these indices. So however, usually when doing binary search, whenever I find the element, I need to do a break. So you can either place a break here whenever you find, so it's one solution. However, you can, if you don't like to use a break, you can place a condition here, and you say, for example, and index equal minus 1. It means as long as you didn't change the value of index, because it starts with index, we started with index equal to minus 1. So as long as the index is equal to minus 1, you will repeat all this stuff. So whenever you change the index, so obviously index would be equal to a number, a positive number, greater or equal to 0. So this condition will be false, and you will exit the loop. So either you place a break here, or you can place an index here. So I will keep this, so it's because it's new. And when we get out of the loop, we need to check. So if index is equal to minus 1, it means I didn't find the element. So printf percentage d was not found. Otherwise, we have found it at index. So it's the same as the printf here as the previous exercise. Was found at index. So let's run. So obviously we need to read the array in sorted. So let's see what we have. So we have n, we didn't declare n. Okay. And val, it's not value, it's called val. Okay. So run. So let's enter. Let's say we have 7 elements. So I will enter directly into a sorted array. So I will not make any tests. And let's say that I want to find the 3. So yes, 3 was found at index 1. So here we don't look. So if you want, you can place some printf here to check the middle. So we can printf the middle to see how the middle is changing and the lower and upper values are changing. So let's see if it works for a value that is not in the array. So let's say 4. And then I will look for 0. So 0 was not found. So this is it for this exercise. So it's very important to review it and to study it well, because it's one of the most important algorithms in C. And again, if you have any questions, do not hesitate to drop me a message, and I will answer you back. And again, thanks for watching.